Algebra of a complex number. In algebra of a complex number, just we have to see how to add, subtract, multiply and divide the complex number. So this is one of the simple topic you already done in 11th and 12th. Just we are repeating here the definitions. So first of all, we already seen a complex number is a number which is written in the form of this a plus ib form. Okay. In some cases, this complex number is written as z is equal to a plus jb. Okay, this is actually mainly in electrical problems because there is I is used to denote the current. So they use a j as a complex number where j is a square root of minus 1. So I or the j, the value of that is a root of minus 1. Okay, generally we follow the first notation. We are going to stick with the first notation only. But in some cases, yes, if j is there, remember that j is nothing but it is iota only and its value is a square root of a minus 1. That's a complex number. We already discussed about that. Now, whenever we have to add the complex number or subtract the complex number, it is simply the addition or the subtraction of their corresponding components. So, very simple definition and straightforward. It's like a matrices only. but now, to multiply a complex number, there is no need to by heart this rule. Just you'll come to know that if we take a term by term multiplication, if we take a1 multiplied to the a2, we get a1 a2 term. This is the first term. If we take then b1, ib1 into ib2, that is I square b1 b2, that I square is a minus 1. So we get this second term minus b1 b2. So there is ib1 into ib2 is a minus b1 b2. That is a real part of multiplication. And when you multiply this a1 with ib2, so we get I times a1 b2. And similarly, if we multiply this with here, there is b1 a2. So indirectly, we got imaginary part as a1 b2 plus b2 a1. Okay, a1 b2 plus b2 a1. That about the imaginary part, this one. So that about a multiplication. No need to by heart anything. Automatically, you will come to know how to get multiplication and the addition. What about division that you learnt in 12th? Yes, how the division is conducted? Division of a complex number? Yes, anyone? How to do the division of a two complex number? Someone is here on the chat. Yes, componendo, dividendo. Okay, so I think Rishang is saying componendo and dividendo. Okay, so
rationalize.
Yes, it is not componendo, dividendo. Rationalize or multiplying by the conjugate of a denominator. It is not rationalize also. Okay, or you say rationalize. But yes, we are multiplying by conjugate of a denominator. Yes, that is a rationalize, you can say. So let I show you a definition. Okay, first of all, this multiplication of a complex number, this is already we seen in Cartesian form. But remember, it's very simple in a polar form. Whenever we multiply two complex number in a polar form, there is a multiplication of a magnitude. So mod of z1 into z2 is mod z1 into mod z2. That is first property. And second, amplitude or argument of z1 into z2 is argument of z1 plus argument of z2. So that about a second property. So the multiplication, this multiplication is very simple that in polar form. So whenever we have to multiply the complex number, it is better to multiply in a polar form. Calculation becomes more simple there. Come to the division now. So here the properties of a division are there. If z is equal to z1 upon z2.
Sir.
Yes.
Hello, sir. Let us note down the previous slide which you just forwarded.
Previous slide. You are noting it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. These are PPT with you, na? So you can. Okay. But take a time. No issue. Okay, write it.
So in the last formula, shouldn't it be amplitude z1 plus amplitude z2?
Yes, correct, correct. My mistake. There is a correction in the formula. It is a print typing mistake actually. So you should do a correction. Yes, here should be amplitude of Z1. This should be Z1. Amplitude of Z1 plus amplitude of Z2 is amplitude of Z1 into Z2. Correct. Good. Good observation. Okay. Once you complete the writing, tell me. We'll see the division formula then.
Completed, sir.
Okay, good. So here is a formula for division, z equal to z1 upon z2. Now this is the formula obtained by rationalization. How we can get that formula? Just I will show you here. Already we seen, suppose that we assume that suppose z1 is x1 plus iy1 and z2 is x2 plus iy2. Whenever we have to divide the two complex number like this, we have to multiply by conjugate of a denominator. That means the conjugate is x2 minus iy2 divided by that x2 minus iy2. So this is the conjugate of this denominator, this one. This is, if it is z2, it is a z2 bar. And now, just like multiplication of a two complex number, we have to multiply it. So obviously the numerator is by multiplication of two complex number, and denominator is like a plus ib into a minus ib. It is a square minus b square form, but that minus I square become minus, so it become a plus. So x2 square plus y2 square, this is because of that multiplication formula. So this is in Cartesian form. Okay, in Cartesian form, we can do it by multiplying the conjugate. In polar form, this multiplication is again a very simple, division is again a very simple. Whenever we divide a two complex number in a polar form, in this polar form, what happened, you can observe, that division of two complex number. Here is again my mistake. Here is R1 slash R2. Okay, I should write R1 upon R2. R1 upon R2 into e raised to I. So I'll write it here. It should be like R1 upon R2 into e raised to I of theta 1 minus theta 2. So this is the way we get that. So modulus of the division of two complex number is the modulus of individual divisions. So mod of z1 upon z2 is mod z1 upon mod z2, that way. While amplitude, here is again the same mistake happened. This should be z1 here. Okay. So amplitude of z1 upon z2 is amplitude of z1 minus amplitude of z2. So that about the division formula. So there is subtraction of the angles or arguments. So complete it. Once you finish, tell me. This is the last definition that we have. So four definitions we learned: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So out of that, generally the tricky one are multiplication and division only. The tricky means, yes, nothing you have to by heart it. You should understand what is happening there. So how to multiply, how to divide, and what happens in a polar form. That is one more important thing. That's one. So are you completed or you want a time? Now if I don't have any response, I will move to the next slide then. Are you finished?
Yes,
sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So the examples, no? The examples based on the algebra. So few of the things we have to do it to simplify the equations. Now, these are very simple questions actually. Rarely comes in the exam. Generally, the main numericals which are coming in the exam are after De Moivre's theorem. So that will start in the next sessions mainly. So this is just elementary articles of this complex number. We are given x and y are real numbers. If x and y are real, solve this equation. What is the main key to solve this problem? Anyone?
Yes, sir. We will equate the real part with the real part of this.
Very good. Very good. Yeah, you are correct. Okay. So that's correct. So just you have to simplify this complex number first from the left hand side, and it is right in standard complex form, like a real plus imaginary part. And then we can equate real with real and imaginary with imaginary. We get two equations for two unknown x and y, and we get the values of them. Okay. So let me start. What should be done in first step here? In solution, yes, what should be done? Obviously, the cross multiplication. So, if we multiply this ix into 3x plus y minus ix plus 1 into 3y plus 4i is equal to 0. Obviously, this denominator we are cross multiplied there. This is the just cross multiplication is done. Now, let me just do a term by term multiplication. So this is a 3x square I. Then we have xy again I. That's one. Now here we do the multiplication minus, I will keep the bracket. So this is a 3xy I. Then multiply with ix with a 4i. This is a 4xi square. So it is a minus 4. Because I square is a minus 1. Then let me multiply this 1. So this will be as it is a 3y plus 4i. That's 1. So just term by term multiplication is done. Okay, as the question is very simple, I'm going little slow here. Or you can drop some steps also if you want. Right now, we are collecting the iota terms together. And the terms which are free from iota, let me first find out which are the terms free from iota. First, we have the iota. There is also the iota.
That will be minus 4x.
Minus 4?
X.
X. Okay, just, yeah, correct, correct. Minus 4x. I missed that. Very good. So, here it should be 4x only. Okay, good. That's one. So, these are only the real term. But if you take minus inside, what is the real term we left here is a 4x minus 3y, 4x minus 3y plus I times. Now we'll observe this is 3x square plus xy. So these first two terms as it is. Here minus 3xy, minus 3xy, and I think it is a minus 4. Okay, now already we are saying this complex number is a zero complex number. If the complex number is a zero, if and only if it's both real and imaginary part should be zero. So we are getting two equations here now. One is a 4x minus 3y should be zero. And the second, this is a 3x square minus 2xy minus 4 equal to zero. So we have two equations for two unknown. Just we have to solve it and we should get the values of x and y. So obviously from one, we can get the value of x in terms of y or value of y in terms of x, and we can go further here. So it is better Yes, it's better to find the value of y from this first equation only. So what I will do it, I will write from here, y is equal to 4 by 3x. Is that? So we'll give this as equation 1 and this as equation 2. So these are the 1 and 2 now. So by 1 and 2.
Just
a minute. It's a 3x square as it is, minus 2xy is a y value is a 4 by 3x minus 4 equal to 0. Now the task is left to solve this equation for x here. So 3x square, you'll observe if you take LCM like 3 cross multiply by 3. So this is the 9x square minus it is a 8x square minus 12 is equal to 0, and it gives us the equation, quadratic equation for x square, as x square minus 12, or x square is equal to 12. So x is, yes, what should be the value of x? Yes, anyone? If x square is 12, what is x?
Plus minus
2 root 3.
Plus or minus 2 root 3. Okay, root if you want complete solution, plus or minus. So this is the first thing we got it here. We got the value for x. Okay, it is a 4 into 3. So plus or minus 2 root 3 is the correct answer here. And now by 1, okay, after this we can say by 1, if we replace the value of x, so y equal to, yes, anyone? Obviously, plus or minus will come there.
8 upon root 3.
Okay, 8 upon root 3. Very good. 8 by root 3 is the correct answer. And that's the end of the question. We got both x and y, for which we have that equation, have the 0 as answer there. Or that we solved the equation indirectly. We got a solution of equation.